Hello friends, welcome in today's class. Today we are going to discuss Chapter 12, Simple Machines Part 3. If you like my video, please like, share and don't forget to subscribe. At the end of this topic, you will be able to understand. In the Part 2 of this chapter, we see what is an inclined plane and a wedge. A slanting plank, which is used to lift a weight, so that we have to bear lesser weight, and lifting becomes easier. Such a slanting plank is called an inclined plane. Steeper the slope of the plank, we have to bear greater weight. And gradual the slope of the plank, we have to bear lesser weight. A sharp tool, which formed on joining two inclined planes, such a tool is called a wedge. Now, let's see the next topic, a lever. A lever is one of the basic form of simple machine. It helps us to lift the loads with lesser efforts. In the picture, you can see a worker who is trying to shift a big stone with the help of long and strong crowbar. Such a machine is called a lever. A lever has three parts, namely, effort, load and fulcrum. Now, let's see these parts, one by one. The first part of a lever is fulcrum, the support at which the rod of a lever is rested is called a fulcrum of a lever. The lever rotates about the fulcrum. Now, we will see the second part of a lever, that is, load. The weight lifted by a lever, or the force against which the lever acts, is called load. The arm of the lever, from the fulcrum to the load, is called load arm. Now, let's see the third part of a lever, that is effort. The force applied on the other end of the rod to lift the load is called the effort. The part of lever from the fulcrum to the effort is called effort arm. Now, we will discuss types of levers. There are three types of levers, depending upon the position of the effort, the fulcrum, and the load. That are lever of the first order, lever of the second order and lever of the third order. Let's see these levers one by one. Let's see the lever of first order. Let's do simple experiment. For this we required a pencil, a ruler and a paperweight. Now, place the pencil on the flat surface. Then, place a ruler on the pencil at right angles with it. Put a paperweight on one end of the ruler. Now, press the other end of the ruler with your finger to lift the weight. Now, can you tell me which are the load arm, the effort arm, and the fulcrum of this lever? Here, you can see the distance between paperweight to the pencil is load arm. The distance between pencil to hand is effort arm, and pencil is the fulcrum of the lever. From this, we can say that when fulcrum of the lever is in between the load and the effort, then it is a lever of first order. Examples of the lever of first order are seesaw, scissor and crowbar, etc. Now, let's see the second type of lever, which is lever of second order. Sometimes, we use an opener to remove the cap of the sauce bottle. To remove the cap, the opener is rested on the cap of the sauce bottle as shown in the figure. And we apply a force on the opposite end of the opener to pull it upwards. Then, the cap is pulled up as the opener rotates. Can you identify where is the load, fulcrum, and the effort in this case? Here, we can see the bottle cap, which acts as a load. The upper side of the opener acts as a fulcrum. And the force applied by our hand to pull the cap is effort. Here, we can see the load is in the center, the fulcrum on one side, and the effort on the other side. From this, we will define the lever of second order. When load is in the center, the fulcrum on one side, and the effort on the other side, such a lever is called a lever of second order. Examples of lever of second order are wheelbarrow, nutcracker, etc. Now, let's see the lever of third order. Do you know how do we lift the object using tongs? When we lift the object, load is at one end of the arms of the tongs, as shown in the picture. And we apply force or effort in the middle of the arms. It means the effort is applied in the middle of the lever, while the fulcrum and the load are at the opposite ends. From this, we will define the lever of third order. When the effort is in the center, the fulcrum on one side, and the load on the other side, such a lever is called a lever of third order. Examples of lever of third order are fishing rod, cleaning mop, etc. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please like, share, and don't forget to subscribe.